Hello children, I welcome you all once again to your English class. I hope you all are doing fine. Children, for today's English lesson, we are going to continue with the 15th chapter, Future Tense. We have just two exercises remaining of this chapter. Then we can move ahead with the next chapter. So, in this one, let's see what we are being asked to do. You have this exercise on page number 83. Read the following passage and fill in the blanks with appropriate forms of verbs given in brackets. You can use any tense form as required. The first one has been done for you. While buying, that means buy was there, we have to write buying. Gardening tools, one has to be careful. Once you dash, which tools you dash? You dash to visit the nearby market soon to pick up and choose the right tools. So children, the first blank you see, once you have determined. So we are going to start with this exercise, exercise L. It's on page number 83, number 1. Okay. So we have, no numbering is there, so we are just going to use a blank. Once you have determined. Okay, next one, you require. It will be in present tense. With you, we have to write a plural verb. You dash to visit the nearby market. So you, with you, we are using plural verb. So have, you have to visit. Okay, children. Now, one should never dash a tool, one should never buy a tool. It will remain in this form only, buy. Which has a handle that is painted to hide the poor quality of the wood underneath. Handles made of steel or fiberglass are stronger. Okay, so beaver, so we can use R, is, and here. Amber, all those things. So now, but they are expensive. Okay, now, my father loved gardening. It will be loves because my father is singular. Loves gardening and he recently dashed a few tools. It's an action of the past, so it will be bought. Bought, okay? Now, he also bought in past only. And a lawnmower, one of our most energetic discussions. Focus. Okay, on how, so present form, on how to take care of plants. He dashed a neem sapling last week. He planted, because it's past, so we will be using planted. Okay, now he dashed a nursery tomorrow, so he will be visiting. He will be visiting a nursery tomorrow. Buy more plants. I like dash the pruning knife. I like using the pruning knife to cut off shoots from the small lemon tree. Together we dash in the upcoming garden festival next week. Together we will participate. Yes children, so this is all we have to do in exercise L. Please pause the video and finish it up. Now we are moving ahead with exercise and let's see what we are being asked to do. Rewrite the following sentences according to tenses mentioned in brackets. The rabbit jumped into the burrow and disappeared fast. Okay, so number one, the rabbit had jumped into the burrow and disappeared fast. Okay, children, now moving to number two. The painter paints our village scene. Past continuous. The painter was painting children. Number three now. All the residents enjoy the magic show. All the residents will be enjoying. The magic show. Number four. The class monitor made a list of talkative children, present continuous. The class monitor is making is our verb. Continuous, present continuous, making a list of talkative students. Okay, children, now please finish this up. Number five. The motorists follow the directions for a road diversion in spite of inconvenience. The motorists will follow. Okay, children, so we are done with this exercise and we have finished the chapter as well. So let's move ahead with the next chapter, because we are done with this chapter, nothing to expand here. So I hope you are done with this. Active and passive voice is going to be a lengthy chapter, little bit more explanation, rules. But yes, that would be worth it, because that will help you understand how the subject becomes object and how object takes the form of subject. Okay, and how we can write them. Now, active and passive voice. Children, the voice, okay, you have to understand this. Let me write the chapter's name first. okay? So voice is that form of verb which indicates whether the subject is the doer or the action or something is done to it. So I told you we will understand how subject becomes object and object becomes subject. So this will help us when you are changing the voice, when you are working with the voice, you will understand how the role interchanges. Whether the subject is a doer, doer is someone, D-O-E-R, doer, okay? That means the person who is performing an action. Yes, it can be an animal as well, any one. Now, doer. And then we have action, okay? So then we have the someone who on whom the action is done. Someone on whom the action is done. We can also write something. Something or someone on whom the action is performed. Okay? So we will be knowing about these two things when we learn about the correct use of voice. Okay, children? So the subject in the sentence is a doer. You know, when we are talking about some verb, let me write the sentence first. Okay? Very simple sentence to begin with. The cat chased the mice or mouse, okay? Now the cat chased the mouse. You see, who is chasing? The cat, right? So this is the subject and the doer of this action, chasing, running after. So this is, this activity, this action is being done by the cat. So this is the doer. Now, this chasing is done on whom? That means we are performing the action on whom? On the mouse. So, this one will be our person on, or obviously, on whom or which action is done. Yes, children? So, this is it. Now, if you have understood this, you may also know that we have subject and we have object, right? The subject is the person, the subject has to be the person who is doing the action, doer, okay? Object on whom the action is being performed, okay? So, the cat is chasing whom? Chasing what? Chasing the mouse. So, now, see here, Namina sang a song. In your book, you had this page number 84. Namina sang a song. Subject is our Namina. Verb is sang. The past tense of sing. And a song is an object, right? It's something. Now, Britney Spears sang a song. So, subjects, Namita and Britney Spears are the subjects and object because they are doing this action. What action they are doing? They are singing. They sang. So here, therefore the word sang is transitive because they have object. A song is an object. When the subject of a sentence does an action, which we say that, then we say the sentence is in active voice. So yes, now if I said this one, children, because if I am saying the doer is doing something, the subject is doing something. So, now when this thing happens, the subject of the sentence is doing something. The cat chased the mouse. So the cat is doing something. The subject is doing something. In this case, children, what we are going to say? We are going to say that this is in active voice. Okay? When the doer is what? Who is the doer? When the subject is the doer. Now moving to this one. Now let's see how we can change this, if we can. A cat chased the mouse. The mouse was chased by the cat. Okay, so now you see who is chasing. Still the cat is chasing, okay? So the subject, this one, is no longer the subject. But yes, the subject becomes the object. In this case, this one, the object becomes the subject. That means the mouse was chased by the cat. In this case, we see that this one, in which the object becomes the subject, this will be known as passive voice. Yes, children, this is passive voice. Now moving ahead, let's see. When the subject is not the doer, so yes, doer is who is chasing. Still the cat is chasing and not the mouse. The mouse is still the person who is running, okay? Which is running or who is running. So this one is being chased. So the cat is still the doer, the person or the animal which is performing the action. Yes, now let's see, we have the first exercise of this chapter. Exercise, okay, let's finish that. This exercise is on page number 84, number 1, okay. The parcel was delivered by the postman. See, the parcel was delivered by the postman. Who is delivering, children? Try to identify who is delivering. I told you that the doer of the action, that means delivering is a job, is an action. Who is doing it? Yes, the postman. So the postman here, the doer is in the object. Okay, the parcel is not the doer. The parcel is being delivered. So here we see this one will be in our, yes children, passive voice. Number 2. Sita painted a portrait. So see, Sita is our subject and who painted it? Sita only painted it. So in this one, subject is the doer. So we are going to write active voice. Yes, children, number 3. The teacher distributed the answer sheets. So who distributed? The teacher. The subject only is the doer. So again, we are going to write passive. The poem was written by John Keats. So who wrote the poem? John Keats. So John Keats is the subject and it is not in the subject part, it is in the predicate part, acting as object. So here it will be, okay, this one, children, will be active. Then we have this one as passive. Number 5. I will pluck all the flowers in the evening. Who is going to pluck? I. So I is in the subject only. So yes, this is he is the doer. He or she is the doer. So this one will be in active voice. Okay, children, number 6 now. Rishan had completed the project. Who has completed, children? The doer is Rishan. So it is in the subject part. So we are going to write it as active voice. Number 7. The thief was caught by the police. Who caught the thief? Police, right? So police is in the object part. So this will be passive. Okay, children, now use of passive voice. The active voice is generally used while conveying an idea or thought, okay? But sometimes the use of passive voice is required if the doer of action is not known. If you do not know who has done the thing, so you can change it into, you can frame the sentence into passive voice. Now, if the stress is more on action rather than the doer of the action, so if we are not focusing on who has done the action, but we are focusing on more on what? On what is the action? Like a cucumber was chopped. So what is being chopped is not important, but it was chopped. So a cucumber was chopped. Who has done it doesn't matter. Okay, so you can add the subject or doer, or you can skip it. So we can definitely write it in positive, like passive. So you can choose not to write the by me, by you. Okay, so the chopping of the cucumber is more important than who chopped it. Yes, the action is important. Now, if the emphasis is on the thing or the person who receives the action, yes, we don't need to talk about the doer, we need to talk about on whom the action is being done. Like the letter was delivered, so this thing was delivered, and that is important. Doesn't matter who delivered, okay? So now, while changing a sentence from active to passive voice, the following points have to be remembered. The first one, the object of the verb in the active voice becomes the subject in the passive voice. Okay, let's see the rules, how you are going to identify. I hope you have finished this, children. So we won't be doing much, or we can do one thing, we can carry this on in our next video lesson. For today, we can just drop this part, okay? And we will meet again in our next video lesson. Till then, children, please take care of yourself and your family. Bye-bye.